Yo, what is up, Fabric community? Welcome to the May edition of the Fabric Monthly Update. I'm Patrick LeBlanc, Principal Program Manager for Microsoft Fabric, here to bring you all the latest and greatest Fabric features and updates. We're excited to be here at the Build Conference and look forward to meeting you, and guess what? Learning about all this great stuff together. Before we jump into the updates, if you want to learn more about the items in this video, check out the Fabric Update blog for details about these items and so many more. All right, enough of all this talking. You know how we like to do? Let's kick things off with the Fabric platform. This month, we're announcing the preview of Shortcut Transformations. Shortcut Transformations allow data to be transformed as it's integrated into Microsoft Fabric. This includes converting data formats to delta tables or applying AI transforms to some unstructured data, such as summarizing text, translating content, or even classifying documents. Now, this is definitely something you want to check out. Okay, let's get into some data engineering. First up, SPN support for user data functions. This feature enables organizations to integrate their apps with user data functions in Microsoft Fabric, ensuring compatibility with their enterprise identity and access management systems. With SPNs, it's possible to implement applications that can call a user data function without requiring a user credential, kind of like using my credential to make those function calls. Instead of using that, you can use the SPN. In addition, facilitating automated processes and simplifying the management of complex applications. It aligns with the Zero Trust security model, providing a secure method where user data functions serve as the link between your application and your data in Fabric. Next up, private library support for user data functions. So before we get into this, what are private libraries? Now, these are libraries that consist of code created by you or your organization. So now with that, we all know data engineering can be particularly challenging due to issues such as data quality and complex analytics. These private libraries can help make things simpler and more consistent, all while enabling the secure use of proprietary code within your team. So think about this, right? Someone in your organization has created a custom library which contains scripts or modules for internal business logic. Now you can upload those to your Fabric user data functions. Once that's done, this can significantly enhance and improve developer productivity across your organization by allowing the reuse of these libraries to automate various processes across different teams and our departments. Okay, now let's get into some data science. First up, standalone Copilot and Power BI now supports Fabric Data Agents. You can now use Fabric Data Agents with standalone Copilot and Power BI to easily connect to your data in the OneLake and get the insights you need. It simplifies how you explore your data. Think about this. You can ask questions and analyze data directly from the Copilot experience, saving you from switching back and forth through different tools. If you have the right permission, Copilot makes data retrieval seamless and accessible, all while keeping everything in one place. Next up, Fabric Data Agent integration with Microsoft Copilot Studio. It's in preview. You may be thinking, well, Patrick, what does this mean? Well, what this means is you can now integrate data agents into your custom Copilot agents, which can connect to channels like Microsoft Teams and Microsoft 365 Copilot. Plus, these agents can access data from where? The Fabric OneLake. So think about data in your lakehouses, your warehouses, Power BI semantic models, and even your KQL database. All while respecting user permission. So here's the best part though. User agents can not only fetch data to answer questions, but it can also take actions like sending emails or automating tasks. It's just a brilliant way to make data exploration and workflow seamless, all within the same tools, guess what, that you already use. I'm excited about this one. Let's get into some warehouse updates. First, the preview of Warehouse Snapshots. So think about this. As a data engineer, Maintaining and managing data consistency during ETL processes can be very, very challenging. I was a data warehouse developer for a long time, and my analysts always were like, hey, can I go read this data at a point in time? Well, this month, we're excited to announce the preview of Warehouse Snapshots, which enable exactly that, right? This feature provides a stable, read-only view of your data warehouse at a specific point in time, ensuring uninterrupted analytics and reporting for those data analysts. A warehouse snapshot captures a read-only version of the data warehouse, and we keep it for about 30 days, right? It's maintained, it's retained for about 30 days. This allows data engineers to offer analytical users a consistent data set. They don't have to worry about anything, even as changes, as real-time updates are happening. So what an analyst can do, they can run and select queries as of that point in time without my data engineering ETL interfering with their queries. This is a big one. This is exciting. Let's get into some real-time intelligence, or RTI, like I like to call it. First up is unlocking multi-schema support for event streams, right? And so what does this mean? This gives you the flexibility to design unique data transformation paths by selecting a specific schema. You can view and update inferred schemas, correct any inaccuracies, and even preview data in an organized way by filtering based on the selected schema. So plus, the event stream ensures that each schema is mapped to its source for easy transformation design. If a source isn't automatically identified, you'll get a prompt to map it manually, keeping everything transparent and efficient. Okay, next up, we're announcing Entra ID authentication support in event streams. You may be thinking, Patrick, what does this mean? Well, with Entra ID authentication support available in event streams, you can now connect to more than 11 sources and destinations, enabling more options for data connectivity and ingestion. All right, so the last update, a really big one. We're announcing continuous ingestion from Azure Storage to Event House using Azure Events. So what this means is this feature streamlines data ingestion from your Azure Storage accounts to a Microsoft Fabric Event House. So once you're connected to your Azure Storage, any new files that are uploaded, so let's say you upload a CSV file, any new files that are uploaded to the storage account are automatically ingested into the destination table without requiring any complex ETL pipelines. This enhancement simplifies the data loading process, saving time and effort. Let's get into some data factory updates. We only have one this month, but it's a big one. Native change data capture support in a copy job. CDC, a change data capture in a copy job, what it does is it automates the replication of data changes, including inserts, updates, and deletions from a source to a destination. It ensures seamless synchronization, reduces manual effort, and improves integration efficiency by processing only changed data, right? Additional features include flexible incremental copy options and optimized performance, minimizing the load to your source systems upstream, right? You gotta check this one out. This has been a journey of updates, but I'm not quite done yet. I have one more for all the developers out there. Introducing the Fabric CLI. The Fabric CLI is a command line interface for Microsoft Fabric that provides a file system inspired terminal based method to interact with your Fabric environment. It allows users to explore, manage, and automate workspaces, items, pipelines, and more using commands like ls, cd, and run, right? It can be used both interactively and in scripted workflows. The design aims to be fast, intuitive, and suitable for developers, analysts, and administrators working with Fabric regularly. This is for everyone, regardless of which persona you are. Definitely a must try. The Fabric CLI is built on public APIs, including Fabric REST, OneLake, and Microsoft Fabric ORM endpoints. It simplifies these APIs into a more intuitive command layer intended to help developers increase efficiency and automated tasks. That's a wrap for this month. But remember, if you want to connect with others and get answers to your questions, visit our Fabric Community forums at aka.msfabriccommunity. Or if you just want to go straight to asking questions, head to aka.msaskfabric. The forums are highly active, populated by both experienced users and Microsoft Fabric experts who are eager to assist. Also, before you leave, check out the May 2025 playlist, which contains several demos from this month's update. And remember, we're always listening. If there's a particular demo you would like to see, if you have any questions or comments about how we're doing, you know, if you want to provide us some feedback, you know what to do. Post it in the comments below. Okay. If this is your first time here, be sure to hit that subscribe button. If you like this video, give it a big thumbs up. And as always, from Microsoft and this guy, thanks for watching, and we'll see you next month.